What a unique period in time we are living in. It's hard to digest it all, but we are writing history each and every day. 2020 has brought some major obstacles and challenges, while at the same time provided us unparalleled insight and opportunity. How do we make sense of it all? Am I helping enough people? Am I being too opportunistic? What activities should I be doing that aren't tone deaf to the world's greater challenges? I'm Joel Burstein, CEO and founder of Keep It Simple Training and Development. We specialize in helping people communicate both effectively and efficiently in business development, management, and customer service. If I could sum up 2020 so far, it's that it has made all of us get out of our comfort zone. The good thing about comfort zone is that we grow, but the bad is that growth is hard. It's exhausting because we lack systems and processes to be effective and efficient. So today, I thought I would share four of our best practices that have been employed by our clients to make transitioning to this new comfort zone a bit more smooth. Number one, get comfortable using all virtual platforms. Consider it like when you used to travel to work. We probably had a main way of getting from our house to our office. If there was a traffic jam and we were running late, we typically had a backup route. If we didn't, we could easily pull out our phones and find alternate roads. Using virtual meeting platforms is much the same. Sometimes your headphones work, sometimes not. Sometimes the headphones work, but not the microphone. Sometimes the microphone works, and not the camera. Sometimes you just have to call. Be prepared virtually, as you used to be on the road. Number two, does anyone know why meetings are in blocks of 30 minutes or an hour? We used to have these great built-in breaks during the day. We would congregate with our peers at random spots around the office. The restroom, the kitchen break room, maybe the water cooler, maybe it was outside on our way to lunch. Building lobbies, and even the elevators. Wherever it was, we've lost those opportunities to connect. The result now is that we schedule meetings too close and back to back, so we inadvertently lost that regular change of scenery and human interaction we used to have. There's an old saying, if you give yourself 2 weeks to complete a task, it'll take 2 weeks. But if you give yourself an hour, you'll get it done in an hour. So try this. Ask the people participating in your meetings if it would be okay to shorten your meeting. As 1 hour meeting, shorten it to 50 minutes. And your 30 minute meeting, shorten that to 25. You'll be surprised how much more focused everyone is and how pleased they'll be to get a few minutes back in their day. Number three, focus on helping, not just selling. At this stage, the road to recovery starts with revenue. It's important that we find ways to get back to business, which involves the movement of capital. Money must start flowing again for the financial system to get back to normal. We can't hide from our money asks forever. However, it is important to remember that we chose this field because we wanted to help people. We enjoyed that interaction and genuinely believe that our work provides impact. If you find yourself trying to convince someone too hard, maybe they aren't the right prospect. Business development is not based on convincing people. It's based on finding people who have a legitimate need for what you provide. Finding the right prospect with the right needs takes away all the stigma around being salesy, because now you're actually helping. Find the right prospects, and you'll never have to sell a day in your life. Number four, people not only want to be heard, but they also want to be understood. We've all been through a lot over the last few months, and we all have stories we're anxious to tell. Your family, friends, clients, and prospects are no different. It's important that as we engage with them, we allow them to share. But it's not enough to just listen. We have a unique opportunity to truly understand them, their concerns, and potential needs. So here's one thing to do, and one thing not to do. Do spend time thinking of genuine questions about their families, companies, industries, their world in general. These types of questions people can answer relatively easily because it's about them, which helps people stay in their comfort zone during your conversation, and that's good. Do not try and relate to everybody by rushing to add your own perspective, story, advice, or solution. It's a well-intentioned response to share similar experiences in an effort to connect, which has value and should be done at the right time. But if used too soon, it can be misconstrued as one-upping. Focus first to listen, then understand what they're saying, and then confirm they're okay. After that, feel free to share your experiences. Recovery won't be easy. It never is. And going through this is painful. It's important that we don't forget how hard it has been for so many people. Some we know personally, and others we don't. But we not only have a responsibility to be more humanistic, but also have a responsibility to take advantage of this opportunity to make the world a better place. Stay safe, stay healthy, and most importantly, stay positive.